Hi everyone, this tutorial shows how to create a circular rotating slider using vanilla JavaScript and CSS. We will also use splitting.js for the text animation. Let's get started. Let's look at the HTML structure. First, we add the CDN to get font awesome icons and splitting.js. I add these links in the description so you can easily access them. Then we have a main element that contains the slider. Inside the slider, we have two buttons, the previous and the next. These buttons are styled as arrows using font awesome icons. Next, we have multiple slides containing text and an image. The data splitting attribute is used by splitting.js to create the text animation. Each slide represents a type of pizza with its name and image. Now let's move on to CSS. First, we import a Google font to style the text. We reset the margins and paddings for consistent styling. The background has a radial gradient to give it a glowing effect. The slider is centered vertically and horizontally with Flexbox. The slides have circular shapes with smooth transitions. This transform origin ensures the rotation occurs within the circle, so the slide will have a balanced and centered animation. In this slider, the transition and animation durations of the slide must be equal. These classes animate slides to rotate clockwise or counterclockwise with smooth transitions. We also add a fade effect with the opacity as they complete a full rotation. The buttons have a circular and glassy appearance. Thank you. The control buttons are positioned on the left and right sides. They scale slightly when hovered over, but they will remain static if they are disabled. Now we add the media queries to make the slider responsive. The control buttons are shifted closer to the center for smaller screens to maintain alignment with the layout. The slide size and button dimensions are progressively reduced. After JavaScript, we will return to the CSS and animate the text. We start by selecting all the slides and buttons. The active slide will be initially set to the middle slide. The update slide transforms function calculates the position of each slide relative to the active one. It calculates the difference between the current slides and active indexes. The translation is applied to hide inactive slides, and rotation gives the slider the circular effect. The active slide is styled distinctly with no transformations. The previous button is disabled when the active index is 0. It prevents going back further if the user is on the first slide. Similarly, the next button is disabled when the user is on the last slide. The opacity of each button changes dynamically from its inactive state to its active state. This function handles the rotation for the current slide based on the navigation direction. The slide at the active index gets the clockwise class if the direction is next. If the direction is previous, the slide at the active index gets the counterclockwise class. These classes trigger the CSS animation for a rotating effect. A set timeout is used to remove the class after the animation completes. This must match the duration of the CSS animation, so there will be no disruptions in slide transitions and animations. This function triggers a counterclockwise rotation animation for the current slide. It updates the active index to the previous slide and sets the positions of all slides. This function triggers an animation of clockwise rotation for the current slide. It updates the active index to the next slide and sets the positions of all slides. Finally, splitting.js handles the text animation. The text is visible with smooth animation when it is active. But the text doesn't look nice like this. By adding the data splitting attribute, each character in the text appears with a fade-in and scaling effect, so a dynamic text is revealed. And that's it. We've created a circular rotating slider with smooth animations and text effects. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the bell icon so you never miss out on the latest tutorials. Thanks for watching.